Hey guys, so this is Adarsh and I am back with another lesson in this course Electromagnetic Induction. I hope you enjoyed the previous lessons and you have learned a lot. Now we are looking forward to the next lesson. If you like my lecture, then you can follow me on this link shown on your screen. You can also rate, review and the sharing of the lecture. So now if we talk about the definition of the electromagnetic induction, then we have seen in the previous lecture that the electromagnetic induction is nothing but the generation of the electric current due to the change in magnetic flux through a closed loop or surface. So if we talk about the idea of electromagnetic induction, then the stories begins from the Oersted experiment, which you have learned in the magnetic field chapter. What was the Oersted experiment? The Oersted experiment was that whenever a electric current is passed through a wire, then there will be a magnetic field surrounded the wire, okay, surrounding the wire. So that was the Oersted experiment. So the idea was that when an electric current is passed through a wire, then there will be a magnetic field around it, okay, like this. So this is the magnetic field around the wire. Now if one can think of a magnetic field generated due to the electric current, why one cannot think of a electric current generated due to the magnetic field? So that was the whole idea which comes into picture, and scientists at that time are were trying to explain the generation of the electric current, or trying to obtain the generation of electric current due to a magnetic field. And it succeeded after some experiments and some theories which we are going to deal with. Okay, now look at this picture. We have a circular loop with us and there is a magnet. This is the north pole and this is the south pole, and if we give this velocity to the magnet, and if this magnet is going to this towards this loop, then what can you think, what is the difference when the magnet is at 1 meter away or the magnet is 2 meter away from this loop? What is the difference basically? Yes, the difference is when the magnet is coming towards the loop, then the number of the magnetic field lines is changing through the loop. Okay, so when the experiment was done, scientists perform various various activities to fetch up the generation of electric current due to the magnetic field, and then they concluded that whenever this number of magnetic field lines changes with any particular loop, then there will be a generation of electric current. Okay, so the first activity was that whenever you put bar magnet in front of a loop, and if the bar magnet has zero velocity or zero speed, then there will be a no current in this loop. Okay, but whenever there is a relative motion, whether the magnet is coming closer with the south pole, where the magnet is coming closer with the north pole, where the magnet is going farther with the south pole, or the magnet is going farther with the north pole, then whenever there will be a relative motion between the two, there will be a current in this particular loop in front of the bar magnet. So yahan se hum log conclude kar sakte hain, the very first condition for the electromagnetic induction, that is the relative motion between the loop and the magnet must be there. Okay, so there is relative motion. If there is no relative motion, there will be no current. Now why this relative motion is necessary? Because if we go back to the definition, there will be there is the requirement of the change in the magnetic flux, and if there is a relative motion between these two, then the magnetic flux will change, because the number of magnetic field lines will change through the loop. okay, crossing through the loop. So that is why we need a relative motion, so that we can change the number of magnetic field lines, or hence we can change the magnetic flux through the loop, and then we can find a current. Now if we look at this picture, so in this case, how does the magnetic field or the magnetic flux changes through the coil? Now if we take this coil at the this end, then you can see that only, now if we if we say that this one cross denotes one unit of magnetic field or one magnetic field line, then you can see that only one field line is passing through this closed loop. If the closed loop moves forward in the magnetic field, then as the time changes, you can easily conclude that after some time two fields line will pass, then three field lines, then four, then five, and then it is going to decrease, that 4 3 2 1. So it is like 1 2 3 4 5. So can you see the number of magnetic field lines, and hence the magnetic flux changes? So there will be a current in this. Okay, now if the loop constantly goes in this magnetic field, or if the magnetic field is like infinite, then after some time you can see through this closed loop, let us say here the magnetic field lines passing through the loop is constant, that is 3, so there will be no current. If there is no change in magnetic flux, there will be no current. So it is very important that the magnetic flux through the loop changes so as to obtain the current. So I guess you understand the whole idea about the experiments, that by hit or trial, by hook or crook, we have to change the magnetic flux through the loop where we wanted to produce a current. Now suppose this is a loop, and a magnet is falling down towards the loop, then there will be a change in magnetic flux and there will be an electric current. So this is the whole idea. Okay, so if you like the lesson, then rate, review and share. Thanks a lot.